Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we are going to see how we can create these wavy effects for our website, and this also would be a mobile friendly. So if I change my browser layout, so you can see this is the result which we are going to get. So it is completely mobile friendly, or we can say the responsive. So without any further ado, let's begin. Alright, we are on our code editor. So in my code editor, I have two files, index.html and style.css. So with some text, I have made a div of the class curve div. So we want to curve that particular div. Okay, so inside that I have two tags, h1 tag and p tag. So we will be just working on this style.css file. But before that, I need to link this up for external CSS. Save this. So now we'll be working on it. First, give some universal tag in it so that we can define its margin to 0, and also the padding should be 0. Perfect. After that, we'll be just defining something which is in curved, because we have defined the curved div class, curved div, and inside that you just need to write position relative. Why I'm writing position relative, I will be telling you that in a moment. So height view height should be 100, and give it a background of a color. You can give any color you want, but right now I'm just going with my color. You can also write green, red, anything you want, right? So, and give it a color of a white. Let's write it in a hash code, FFF. Perfect. Now just give it a text align center so that it would be on the center. So now save this, and I have attached my external file. Perfect. Now I will go to my browser, and you can see now our orange color is here and our text is at the center now. So now we'll be working on how we can make wave things. So for that, we have getwaves.io. For that, you can take the SVG of your waves. So here it is. If I'm showing you, you can take any wave you want, and it would be customizable so that you can customize your own wave. Okay, so I will go with this wave simply, and finding my wave to suits me. Okay, this is looking good for me. So what you need to do is to click on this and just copy this SVG. You can download it as well, but right now I'm going to just copy it because I don't need to download it. If it has the option of copying SVG, then why need to download it? Okay, so below that I'm just going to paste it. Perfect. Here. After that, what you need to do is to define something for that, right? So before that, I'm just going to write some class in it. So just write class so that we can differentiate between two SVGs which we're gonna join in that. Okay, so first of all, I will be writing SVG dash bottom for our first SVG, because we are applying it at the bottom of our div. Okay, so it is outside of div. No, we don't want it outside of div. We want it inside. So just copy this. I mistakenly put it outside, and in this, and put it here. Perfect. So now it is inside of that div. So now I'm going to my browser and I'm seeing this. You can see here the wave is appeared, but it is not looking as good as we were thinking, because it is not flowing according to the page. Matlab, it is flowing according to the page, but it is not flowing according to ourselves. Okay, so we will making it solve, and we will resolve it as well. How? You know, I have made this position relative, so now it is gonna work. Just type dot svg, which we have defined the class svg, and then bottom, and sub tag, and then position. Now we'll be making it position to the absolute, because we want to define it positions, right? And after that, left 0, from left we want 0, and from the right, we also from the bottom, sorry, we also want 0. So save this. Now go to your page. Now you can see it is coming at the bottom. So now we have whole control of our SVG so that we can imply it, or we can say we can modify it according to our own. Okay, so we have defined this below SVG. So now we want to make it upwards as well, so that we can see the wavy thing on our whole page. So we'll be doing that as well. So we will get back to our this getwaves.io. So now you can see this thing, right? If you want your waves to go upwards, then it has an upper sign. If you want your waves to go downwards, then it also has downward SVG, right? So again, you need to, if you want to go downwards, yes, I want it because I want to show it to upwards of my page. So just click on this and copy SVG again and go to my code editor in index.html. And now what I will be doing is just putting it here above of my h1 tag and p tag, right? Save this. Also, I'm giving it a class, some class of, earlier I have given svg.bottom, that's why I have written bottom, because I was going to apply a upper svg as well. So to differentiate it, so I just give it a class name itself of top and bottom, right? So I'm just copying it as well. Copy this first, save this, and now before applying any class, let's see how it is gonna look. See, it is looking as perfect as we were thinking, okay? But still, in some cases it is not recognizable, so we need to apply some extra CSS as well. So dot svg not bottom, for that we need to type top and then display and block. Save this file and go to our browser and then reload it. So now you can see this is working as perfect as we were thinking, because if we are doing it, you can see this is a complete responsive, right? So this is how you can make your website wavy and to be more responsive. So now also you can see in the middle it is showing the perfect wave which we wanted, right? So it has a whole variety of waves which you can use. It has the block, which if you want to use a block of different kind, you can customize it on your own. Also, we have this this thing, if you want to upwards, downwards, we have a whole thing, right? And you can also change the color of it according to yours. Also, if you want to change anything, then you can do it as well by going into the code. So right now I have this blue code, right? Blue color, right? So if I want to change it, go to this this fill property and just type something like, if I want to make it red, fill it refers to the color of the SVG, right? So I want to change it to the red. So now go to so now you can see it is red. I think it is not as visible because the orange and red is very similar. Let's make it a yellow. Yellow is shiny, so it will shine separately. Save this. So now you can see this is yellow color. So you can also define, you can go into the code and define any color you want, right? So you can do these things with the waves. So now you know about the wave things, and I'm sure you are ready to apply these things in your website as well. So that's all for this video. If you like this video, then click on the like button. So I will see you in the next video. Till then, take care.